Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Sandesh Pare. I am currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology. In this video, I am going to explore the concept debugging of the Android application. So, at the end of this session, you will be able to define the landscape of the mobile app validation. So let us start with the exploring of the tools which are used for the debugging of the Android applications. Okay, there are multiple tools available for the debugging purpose of the Android applications, and mainly in this session we are going to focus on these five tools. That's our first one is the Android Studio Debugger, okay, and second one is the AD, that is called as the Android Device Monitor. Third one is the Android Debug Bridge. Fourth one, Toast Message, and last one is the Class Log and Logcat Utility. Okay, mainly in this video, I'm going to focus on these five tools which are generally used for the debugging purpose. So let us start by the first one, that is the Android Studio Debugger. Okay. What happens that Android Studio, which generally makes available this debugger to the developer one, okay, in format of the emulators, okay, or you can directly use your physical hardware device to debug this purpose, okay. So mainly emulator is used for the debugging purpose, and using this IDE, you can say that Android Studio. Okay, suppose we are considering we are using the Android Studio, then what can we do that? First we can select device, okay, to debug the app, okay, means on which device you want to debug this app, okay. And the second one is there, you can see the logs, okay, you can set the breakpoints to the execution of the programs, okay, and at that time, okay, whatever the executions are executed, and based on this, which are the values of the variables which are get changed during this execution, okay, you can see it manually by step by step procedure using these breakpoints, okay. So you can run this debugging tool, okay, from the Android SDK which is made available, and then you can take the snapshot of this, capture this snapshots, and you can make the video of this. So using this Android Studio Debugger, okay, in this what happens means we have to build APK signed debug key, okay, and then we have to install it on the physically on the device, okay, or you can use the virtual emulators also, okay. What happens is that you have to first open that Android Studio, okay, and there is one button called as the debug, okay, and whenever you click that, it will ask for the device one, that on which device it should host that application, okay. Then you have to select the particular one, and then it will get executed on that device. So the next tool is the Android Device Monitor, okay. What happens that it is a standalone tool, okay. It provides the GUI, okay, for many Android applications, okay, for debugging and analysis tools, okay, just like one simulator, okay, it is acting there, okay, and it does not require any installation of the particular IDE, okay, like as we discussed earlier that Android Studio we are executing, this is not necessary, okay. So you want only this simulator for the debugging purpose, okay, and it generally have the tools like okay, DDMS, okay, Tracer View, okay, and Hierarchy Viewer, Systrace, Trace View, and Pixel Perfect Magnificent Viewer. These are some of the components which is embedded into this, okay. Using these tools, okay, generally this is called as the Android SDK tools, okay. There are two types of tools, means Android SDK tools and platform tools. These are components of the Android SDK tools which are generally used by the developer, okay, for many reasons. So starting this Android Device Monitor is you have to just, okay, click on the Android Device Monitor toolbar, okay, icon from the menu one. Okay, then you have to select the Android and then Android device monitor. Okay, and one more thing that if you have any problems, okay, if you have any problems running this Android device monitor, okay, you have to just need to take care of the updation process. Okay, you have to update your Android Studio. Okay, then as I said earlier, that you have to take it. Okay, add these tools. Okay, and platform tools sub dictionary is also there. Okay, of the SDK to your path variable. Okay, so this is one overview. Okay, you can see there. Okay, on the Android Studio. Okay, there is one option there that is called DDMS. Okay, you can click on the DDMS so that it should be open in the verbose mode. It is called as the verbose mode, in which there is a device view on the left side. Okay, file explorer view, you can see the multiple files in the project, and then emulator control view is there. Okay, to control the ongoing activities during the project execution. Okay, and the last one is the locket. Okay, that is the fourth one, and which is at the bottom of the window. You can see there. Okay, which are the application tag. Okay, and tests are performed there. You can attach the filters also there. Okay, by this overview, you can analyze and debug the project. So next one is the Android Debug Bridge. Okay, this is in short called as the ADB. Okay, and actually it is command line tool. Okay, which is located in the platform tool dictionary. Okay. For this, there are specific commands are there to perform the certain activities. That are first one is the ADB shell. Okay, to create any Linux shell. Okay, this command is generally used, and after execution of this, you can perform the operations like making a dictionary. Okay, running a file. Okay, and installation of particular apps. Then there are multiple various commands for this purpose, and they are shown there. Okay, just for making dictionary, make dir. Okay, to push the file onto the device. Okay, just like copy the file from the device. That the command is there. Okay, vs with keyboard. So there is one question for you guys, that is what is DBA and what purpose it is used. So ADB is nothing but it provides the connection and communication with the device and emulators. Okay, once it is connected, developers can execute the commands. Okay, which can be used to perform the activities like installation of apps, copying the files, reading and logs. Okay, just as I said earlier. So next one is the toast messages. Okay, toast message is nothing but the one just message window. Okay, we can say it window. Okay, it will just appear for a few seconds on the screen. Okay, and it does not emulate any activity. Okay, and toast examples are there. Okay, just as a volume control. Okay, whenever you press the keys, okay, hardware keys of the volume up and down. Okay, the certain message window is there, which comes on the screen. Okay, but it does not hamper any execution of the ongoing activity. Okay, so when the view is shown to the user, okay, it appears on the top of the screen. Generally one function is there. Okay, to creation the for the app toast message. That format is nothing but the toast make toast makes text. Okay, in that it generally requires the three parameters. One, okay, first one is the context. Okay, in what context you want to display it. Okay, and the second one is the resource ID, and the third one is the duration. Generally what happens that context always is this parameter is used, means in that function only it is toast messages displayed. And second one is the you can use particular resources just like strings. Okay, you can use it and edit text. So whatever their information is there, that is displayed on the toast message. Otherwise you can pass it manually the message whatever you want to show. And third one is the duration, means for what time it should be displayed. So there is one example which is shown there. Okay, and this that gravity is set there. Okay, to make it middleware. Okay, gravity dot center is the parameter, okay, and at the last sentence you can say that according to the x offset and y offset, okay, the midpoint is selected so that it should be center of the screen. And next one is the log class, okay. Log class is generally used to log messages while running the application, okay. Means whatever the activities are going on to it, it is logged and shown to the user one. Generally there are a lot of many types of the logs are there, okay. We have a look on that. That is a error message, warning message, okay, informational message and debugging message, verbose mode message, okay, and what a terrible failure message, okay. So for these kind of the logs, if you want to display this kind of, mainly these are the some categories, okay, of the logs, and if you want to display any message regarding this category, then you have to use that functions. And generally it is used mainly two parameters. That first one is the tag one, okay, whatever tag you want to assign to that message, and second one is the message, okay. Tag for parameter is used to indicate one category from which it belongs to, okay, so that and it can be filtered also, okay. So third parameters is also there, okay. As we can see, the tag and string message, whatever there, and third parameter is the throwable parameter, okay. But it is not compulsory to use this parameter, okay. And the logcat utility is the same as I said earlier, that it is just severity level, okay, by the tag, and you can filter the messages, okay, according to the tags whatever assigned to it, okay. You can access it by on clicking the Android icon there, okay. And whatever the tools we are discussed, that is the debugger, ADB and Android Device Monitor, they can use this logcat utility. So these are some references I used to make this video. Thank you.